This is part two of solving literal equations, which means you've got a formula with more than one variable and you're solving for one of the variables. So this is a tax formula, T equals 3/10 I minus 12,000, and we're going to solve for I. So first you notice there's only I in one place and it happens to be in the parentheses. So there are two ways you can go about doing this. One is to try to simplify the right-hand side so it's only got what's in parentheses first. And you could do that by multiplying by the reciprocal of what's being multiplied outside the parentheses. So we have 3/10 times something. So we can multiply both sides by 10/3. So watch what happens if I do 10/3 on each side. We would have 10/3 times t and 10/3 times 3/10 times I minus 12,000. And when we do that, then the 10/3 times 3/10 cancels, so that what I have on the left side is 10/3 t or 10t over 3. It doesn't matter which way you write it. I'm going to write it as 10/3 t equals, and since these cancel, I just have I minus 12,000. You don't need the parentheses anymore. Now I'm trying to solve for I. So we have I minus something. So what we could do is add 12,000 to both sides to isolate I. So this gives you 10/3 t. And if I add 12,000 to both sides and solve for I, this is what I get. Right. Lastly, I would suggest you write the I on the left-hand side. So we have I equals 10/3 t plus 12,000. So I've solved for I. Now, you could write this a little bit differently. You could write that as 10t over 3. You can get a common denominator. And if you got a common denominator by multiplying the right side by the 12,000 by 3 over 3, you might see it written even a little bit differently. It's possible that you might write this as 10t plus, now if I multiply the top and bottom by 3 over 3, that would give you 36,000 over 3. So then the whole thing would be over 3. So that's another way of getting the same answer. All right, so these are both correct. Now, let's look at the original again, and let's do it by doing the distributive property first. Okay, so we're going to take the same problem, and we're going to go down and try it a different way. So same problem, but I'm going to do the distributive property first and see what happens. Because there's usually more than one way to solve for a variable. So if I do the distributive property, I have 3/10 I. And again, you could write that as 3i over 10 or 3/10 I. I think it's easier to just see it as the coefficient. Minus, now, what do I have here? 3/10 times 12,000. Okay, so we have 3/10 times 10,000. So I can either leave that with a common denominator and write 36,000 over 10, or I can cancel. So again, more options. For the moment, I'm just going to leave it with a common denominator, even though, of course, 36,000 over 10 is the same thing as 3,600. So those of you who wrote 3,600, that's correct too. So then I'm going to, I've done the distributive property. Now what I'm going to do is multiply both sides by the least common denominator. So we covered that's a way to get rid of the fractions in an equation. So since the least common denominator is 10, and by the way, that's why I left it this way, you'll see in a minute, I can multiply both sides of the equation by 10. Okay, I'm going to move this over just a little bit. All right, so if I multiply both sides by 10. Remember, you have to multiply it to every term, also by this. So I have 10t equals, now when I do 10 times 3 tenths I, that'll give me 3i, because the tens will cancel, which is the whole idea of multiplying by the least common denominator. And 10 times the last term over here, the tens will cancel, and I have 36,000. By the way, if I had just written this as 3,600 and then multiplied by 10, I would get back to 36,000. All right, now we're going to solve for I. So I have to add 36,000 to both sides, right? Because I want to isolate the variable I. So I have 10t, add 36,000 to both sides. And now I've got to divide by 3 to isolate the I. So the last thing is divide by 3. So over on the left-hand side, that's what I equals. I'm just going to write it as I equals 10t plus 36,000 all over 3. All right, so that's a different approach to solving the same problem. And let's just go back up. 10t plus 36,000 over 3. Ah, remember that was another way I could have written it before. Remember I had 10 thirds t plus 12,000, and by putting it over a common denominator, I also got 10t plus 36,000 over 3. Oh, here is a geometrical formula. V stands for volume, R is the radius of a circle. The volume equals 4 thirds pi r cubed, actually of a sphere, not a circle. All right, so how are we going to solve for pi? Well, basically there's only pi in one place, and it's easier if you see the coefficient of pi written before it. So you could write V equals, now we have 4 thirds and we also have an r cubed. So what you could do is write 4 thirds r cubed, or write 4 r cubed over 3 times pi. It's easier to see the coefficient that way. And if you multiply by the reciprocal of this fraction in front of pi, everything will cancel and you'll have it solve for pi. So we're going to multiply both sides by the reciprocal, which is 3 over 4 r cubed. And times v on this side, and times 4 r cubed, 3 times pi on this side. So on the right side, everything cancels except the pi, right? So we've solved for pi. And on the left side, we have 3v over 4 r cubed. So pi equals 3v over 4 r cubed. Okay, you could have done this in two steps by, on this second line here, you could get rid of the fraction first by multiplying both sides by 3, and then at the second step, divide both sides by 4 r cubed. But if you multiply by the reciprocal, it's done in one step. Okay, here's another one. V equals x minus y over m, and we're going to solve for m. All right, since this contains a fraction, you can multiply both sides by the least common denominator, which is m. All right, so let's do that. What if I multiply both sides by m? So on the left side, I would have m times v, or I'm going to write that as vm. It doesn't matter if you write m times v or v times m. And on the right-hand side, the m's cancel, so I have x minus y. Now I want to solve for m. There's only m in one place, right? So I just need to divide by the coefficient of m. So if I divide both sides by v, I'm done. M equals x minus y over v. Now, the original problem, v, could have been written as v over 1 equals x minus y over m. And you could have used proportions. If you remember how proportions work, you multiply what's on one diagonal, the v times m. This only works when you have an equation with, they're both fractions on each side. I could write v times m is equal 1 times x minus y. And of course, notice you get exactly the same thing as I had by multiplying by the least common denominator. So you'll still get m equals x minus y over v. All right, so here, that's a lot of examples solving literal equations. Practice, practice, practice. Have fun.